Yeah, I
So
want
you go ahead. You wanted to
to.
say something.
Yeah,
So
I
I
want
don't see it as a problem. So forget it, man.
to.
Don't bother.
I like what you brought in. This is one of the rare times we have a global perspective on our podcast about something which pertains to all of us. So my question to you is fairly simple. My answer mentally to a lot of these problems is to make it small and keep doing what you're doing. What I call in my head a little off the grid. Like this corporate cycle, 9 to 5 days, typical achievement-oriented lives. I have realized that the fact that I have not been so achievement-oriented or at least the typical idea of success doesn't exist for me. It has helped me make these smaller contributions, and there is a lot of fulfillment. Trust me, every Saturday you meet me in the evening, I am glowing in spite of having worked since 4 in the morning till almost 4 in the afternoon, because कुछ ना कुछ गड़बड़ होता ही रहता है। मतलब हम लोग 12 बजे रेडी होगा तो भी होते होते 2 बजे पैकिंग होता है, कुछ ना कुछ होता ही है। फिर कभी कोई मिलता नहीं है, कभी कुछ गड़बड़ होता है, चलो इधर जाते हैं उधर जाते हैं भागने। बट द आइडिया इज दैट फोर व्हाइल वी आर डेड टायर्ड फिजिकली मेंटली ऑल ऑफ अस आर लाइक अलर्ट कि अब नेक्स्ट सैटरडे क्या बनाए खास। तो देन वी आर ऑलरेडी फाइटिंग, ये वाला मस्त होगा, वो वाला मस्त होगा। वी आर ट्राइंग टू गिव द बेस्ट दैट इज पॉसिबल, एंड That is being human after a long time. Luckily, being part of the Vipassana meditation, a bit of seva also. There also, I have found that the same thing. The smaller I keep it, it's a big organization now. The centers are doing reasonably well. People are donating money, but effectively, yeah, right. So, effectively, we are all trying to put in something or the other. Where we are, whether this much or this much, we are all trying to put in and have a human feeling out of it that it's okay, but I can do something where it doesn't matter what happens to me. And do you also agree that this is a good antidote, at least for the small perspective, for this depressing times, for the anxious times, for so many friends?
So a recommended reading for anybody in today's day and age of feeling urban stress is Victor, and you know, most urban people, younger people, millennials especially, and the generation Z's after that are feeling this whole stuck feeling is because you know, it's just they feel okay. So if they're feeling so stuck, recommended reading I would say is Man's Search for Meaning, Viktor Frankl. So yeah, उसने जो किया एंड वॉट ही रोट अबाउट, आई मीन इमेजिन, हियर्स अ मैन यू नो कम्स फ्रॉम अ वेरी वेल टू जूइश फैमिली एंड हिज फैमिली हिज फ्रेंड्स ऑल ऑफ द लाइफ ही नोज दे ऑल गेट हर्डेड इनटू ट्रेन्स टेकन इनटू कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कैंप्स एवरी डे यू डोंट नो वेदर यू गोना लिव ऑन और डाई दैट डे राइट सो गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग यू डोंट नो व्हाट्स गोना हैपन टू यू यू मे डाई ऑफ सिकनेस यू मे डाई ऑफ अ बुलेट You may die of overwork or you may be sent to the gas chamber, right? यही चार है और कोई ऑप्शन ही नहीं है. There's no option कि आज हम बाबा जी खाएंगे. There's no option. And in that, the man could sit and mull about the nature of life, of the nature of happiness, of the nature of purpose, saying, why are we living? क्यों जीना है ऐसा? Because what is the first thing that these concentration camps did was strip you of your humanity. नाम निकाल देते हैं आपका, आइडेंटिटी निकाल देते हैं, यू बिकम अ नंबर, इट गेट्स टैटूड ऑन योर बॉडी, एंड द वे दे ट्रीट यू आफ्टर दैट, विद इन अ वीक द ऑल ह्यूमैनिटी इज लॉस्ट. यू आर जस्ट अ बॉडी, राइट? यू जस्ट अ बॉडी, यू आर यूज्ड फॉर लेबर, यू आर यूज्ड फॉर व्हाटएवर एल्स इज देयर एजेंडा इन लाइफ, एंड दैट्स इट, राइट? एंड इन दैट यू नो एन इंटेलिजेंट ह्यूमन बीइंग लाइक हिम कुड सिट एंड थिंक अबाउट इन दैट. उनको दो ब्रेड मिलता था दिन में, बस थोड़ा सा वॉटरी ग्रुएल मिलता था, उसमें वो बचाते थे, किसी को थोड़ा दे दिया, किसी को नहीं दे दिया, वॉट एवर लिटिल डॉक्टरी ही, यू साइकेट्रिस्ट, बट ऑब्वियसली दे नो बिट ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी. try to help people in whatever way you can. There are no medicines, there's nothing, there's no camp doctor going to look up. So Viktor Frankl, in all that death and the inhumanization of life, could sit and say and pontificate and think about what is the meaning of his own life, what is the search for meaning, what is his search for happiness. And Bunty, he said service to others. There is no, nothing else. If you can, if your life can serve somebody else's life, that's the only meaning you can have. That is a dharma. Finally, what is dharma? You do something. You're a farmer, you're a carpenter, you're a blacksmith, you're a writer. It is never for you. It is for somebody else. So if I'm a writer and I earn money, I mean, if I'm a writer, that writing is for someone else. Somebody or koi anaj ugata hai, wo mere ko milta hai. You understand this?
Yeah.
It's not money. Money is just a way of calculating and helping ease the transition of what do you have and what do I have, and let's just exchange this, and this is what I can do for you. Because I can't directly do things right for 7 billion people. I can write for a few people. The farmer can't make food for 7 billion people. He makes food for a little number of people. And that's how it works. People have put exaggerated importance on value of what they do. And then it becomes a problem where you have to live by the valuation a few people have decided on life and effort. I have this question in my mind for the last 20 years. The lady who comes to clean my house or my office, how different, isn't she spending 14 hours or 12 hours a day working for others, right? Helping somebody else's day get better, okay? Versus a Mukesh Ambani who's also doing 12 hours a day. Now you say, oh God, that's communist thinking, and you know, there's merit-based. Merit-based kisne invented kiya hai? Merit-based has been invented by capitalists, by monarchists. That is what it is. It is just a construct. Merit is a construct. People have to live, people have to get by. What are we taking and what are we bringing into this world that, oh God, there is value being created and value being generated, and yeah, you die. At the end of it, you're dead, right?
Yeah.
Everybody lives in the same nice one place, and you know, koi jhadu mara, koi anaj ugaya, end of the day, mile baat ke ho gaya, kaun sa bank balance hai, kaun sa stock market hai. But humne ye valuation word lekar aaya. We have tried to put value on human life. For me, there is no valuation. Every human life is the same, not just human life. Every animal on this planet, every life form is as important as the other. Unfortunately, human ego has created a pyramid. On the top of the pyramid, we are sitting. On top of that pyramid where we are sitting, there's a little cloud. On that cloud, we have put God. And we think that we're sitting on top of the pyramid and we can touch God and we are directly sort of linked. It's an egoistic construct, sir. Because everybody's thing is, what is the meaning of my life? My life should mean something. I'm super important. Why do you live? Because it's just like fear. Why do you live? What difference does it make? Bunty, at the end of the day, we are all going to die. You keep the karma. Past death, yeah, go, all that aside, that's all constructs of human beings. Have you seen a ghost? Have you seen a spirit? Have you seen anybody coming back and saying, like, oh, yeah, you know? And actually being that, it's a probability, life is a chance. There's a probability you'll become a batsman, there's a probability you'll become a footballer. There's a probability you won't play any sport. There are 25, 30, 40, 50 different conditions that go into making a human being whatever he is. Right? In that, who are we to put a valuation? Oh, valuation daane wala bhi ek chance mein paida hoga. वो भी एक प्रोबेबिलिटी है कि मैं एक इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकर है या मैं एक टॉप लेवल स्टॉक ब्रोकर है और मैं वैल्यूएशन डाल रहा हूँ सब चीजों पर, वो भी एक प्रोबेबिलिटी में ऐसा आदमी पैदा होगा। इन द सेम प्रोबेबिलिटी रामकृष्ण भी पैदा हो गए, रामना महर्षि भी पैदा हो, एक प्रोबेबिलिटी है, ठीक है ना। मोर एंड मोर आई रियलाइज देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन ओशो एंड द स्टॉक ब्रोकर, अगर फर्क है इफ एट ऑल इज टू गिव अप द फैक्ट दैट यू आर वैल्यूएबल। ओशो तो हंसते हैं, बोलते हैं क्या क्या मिलता है, तुम लोग सोच रहे हो कि यू नो यू आर रीडिंग मीनिंग इनटू समथिंग हैपनिंग इन योर लाइफ एंड सेइंग द यूनिवर्स इज लुकिंग आफ्टर मी। यूनिवर्स डजंट नो, इट इज अननोइंग, द यूनिवर्स इज अननोइंग, इट इज व्हाट इट इज, वी डोंट नो व्हाट इट इज, वी क्रिएटेड गॉड कॉन्सेप्ट एंड देयरफॉर वंस गॉड गेट्स क्रिएटेड वी पुट वैल्यू ऑन आवरसेल्फ because you know, hey, we come from God, so we have value. Then we say, okay, this guy has more value, this guy has less value. Who are we to put value? Valuation is in chhod denge na, and I know it's very tough, but there must have been a time in human evolution when there was no valuation, right? People did what they did, and even today they are doing it, right? If you go into the deep Amazon, you go into the islands of Andaman, right? Some islands in the Pacific, some deep tribes in Africa, some deep tribes in Mongolia, right? Central steppes. Each man is important. You know, maybe one guy is elected to just resolve some bloody dispute that arises out of whatever, but there are no dispute. If you see the whole Hawaiian principle of Ho'oponopono, where people sit in the middle and everybody says sorry to the guy who has hurt somebody else. It's the other way. He, what propelled you to cause hurt to somebody?
Yeah.
So, you know, we put... So, you can...
Yeah, so...
So, my thing is, just let me finish, because, you know, the argument to valuation is saying that how else is man able to progress? I'm saying that the best things in life, when it comes to progress, like you take vaccines, like... It was given away free by Louis Pasteur. The best minds in the world gave away their work free. उनका खाना हो गया ना, उनको करने को जो चाहिए वो करने को मिल रहा है ना, they are happy, right? उससे ज्यादा उनको नहीं चाहिए, वो दे दिए. It's us, the Elon Musk of the world and the Steve Jobs of the world and the Bill Gates of the world who do this much and take that much. Today, Bill Gates has patented all the bloody vaccines for COVID, right? Because he wants to do good philanthropy. And we are saying all third world countries, forget it, yeah. Some bloody researcher is sitting on the shoulder of giants. You're taking 150 years of research and building on top of that. So tumhara hai kya, did you start on a blank sheet of paper? Tum kon hai? Wo patent lene ke. That's my question. People are drawing boundaries and sucking the earth and say, this is mine and that is mine. And then they all leave it behind and die and go. And we can't even laugh at them once they are dead. You know, that's so sad. There should be at least a 5-minute conduit where, you know, a person knows he's dead and all the world can stand and laugh at that guy. Go, take your money here. Take.
I guess... Yeah, this is beautiful for having covered a lot of ground in terms of from personal to immediate impact that one can have with one's personality. Looking at the scenario, the kind of times we live in, and the good and the bad things that are happening to us while we are still trying to figure out how to be human. To me, this whole conundrum seems to continue from time immemorial. What is it to be a good human being? What is it to lend value or purpose to one's own life? Meaning, like you said. And on that note, I think you covered us so much ground that anybody who watches this is going to sit and mull over for or against is not really important. The idea is to bring the topic in the mainstream and get a chance to think or rethink. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Mahi, for having the patience to let me ramble.
This was enjoyable. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mahi. Let's connect soon.
Yes.
Bye.
Yep. Bye.